Welcome back to the class. Today we are going to discuss about the peninsular plateau. Peninsular plateau have been categorized into two types. The first one is about the central and the second one is about the Deccan. In the central plateau, in the central we have two plateaus. One is about Malwa. Another one is about Chota Nagpur plateaus. So Malwa plateau, if you go through about Malwa plateau lies between two ranges. What are all the two ranges? The first one is about Vindhya ranges and the second one is about Satpura ranges. Completely the Malwa plateau lies between Satpura ranges and Vindhya ranges. Whereas coming to the Chota Nagpur plateau is to the eastern part of the country near Odisha. Clear? So Chota Nagpur plateau is to the eastern border of the Indian peninsula. And coming to the word peninsula, what is the meaning of a peninsula? The land which has been covered three sides, the land covered by water three sides is called as a peninsula. So as we know that if you go through to the map representation, here we have about the Arabian Sea and here we have about the Bay of Bengal and at the bottom Indian Ocean. So as the land completely covered with the three sides of water bodies, we call it as a peninsula. So India is a peninsular plateau. There is a difference between the peninsular plateau and the Deccan plateau. So coming to the representation of the plateaus, so if you go through to the border of the Gujarat, between two ranges, what as we discussed, one is about Vindhya range, another one is about Satpura range, we have about the plateau region, that is about Malwa plateau. It is completely near to the river. Here we have one of the river, that is about Narmada river. The river is about Narmada river. So Narmada river lies between the Vindhya ranges and Satpura ranges. Here we have about the Malwa plateau. If you go to the eastern border of the country, here we have another plateau region, that is about Chota Nagpur. Chota Nagpur plateaus to the eastern border of the country. Clear, children? And completely, if you go through the bottom or southern part of the country, here in a rectangular shape, we have Deccan plateau. In the rectangular shape, we have Deccan plateau. Here we have completely about Deccan plateau. To the southern part of the nation. So near to the Deccan plateau, or beginning from the Chota Nagpur plateau and the Malwa plateau and Chota Nagpur plateau, two Ghats sections has been formed. What are all the two Ghats sections here? The two Ghats sections are Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. So Western Ghats, as we discussed earlier, these are continuous, whereas the Eastern Ghats are non-continuous. Clear, children? And the hilly regions in the Western Ghats extends the elevation of 2000 meters, whereas the Eastern Ghats covers up to only 900 meters. So if we go through about the land, as the land, the Indian subcontinent slightly tilted towards the east, the elevation range has been variated. The elevation range has been variated variation has been taken. So the first one is about the Western Ghats is about 2000 meters, and whereas to the Eastern Ghats it's up to 900 meters. Clear, children? And if we go through about the connecting between or the connections between the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, here we know the southernmost tip. What is the southernmost tip of our country? The southernmost tip of our country is Kanyakumari. Excuse me, one minute. Sir, map. The southernmost tip of the country is about Kanyakumari. But actually, if we go through about in the before 2008, the southernmost tip of our country is about Indira Point. Indira Point. So because of the submerging of the islands or the Indira Point in the year of 2008 because of the tsunamis, the Kanyakumari has been taken as the southernmost tip of the country. If we go through comparison from Gujarat, the continuous formation of the Ghats sections has been taken part, and where the elevation is about 2000 meters, where we call it as Western Ghats. And here we have non-continuous, as we discussed. So these two, Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, are going to be meet at a location that is about the capital of Kerala, Thiruvananthapuram or Trivandrum. So coming to the highest peaks in the Western Ghats is about Doddabetta. And coming to the Eastern Ghats, we have the highest peaks as this comes under Western Ghats. And coming to the Eastern Ghats, children, in Eastern Ghats, the highest peak is about Aromakonda, or another one, Aroyakonda. So these are all the two highest peaks of the Eastern Ghats. The place where these two are going to mix, one of the peak has been raised, that is about Anaimudi. So comparing to the Indian Peninsula, to the north the highest peak is about Kanchenjunga, and to the south the highest peak is about Doddabetta. Clear? So today we are going to write some important notes along with the explanation regarding about the peninsular plateaus. Peninsular plateaus have been beyond this two variations, Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, or the Central Peninsular Plateau or the Deccan Peninsular Plateau. Peninsular plateaus have been categorized into six types. So what are all those six types? The first one is about Dharawa. Second one is about Kadapa system. Third one is about, if you go through about Deccan Plateau system. So in the meanwhile, we have six peninsular plateaus or the plateau regions which has been taken part in our country. Now we are going to know about each and everything step by step. I request all the students to note down the points regarding this. Along with the notes, I am going to give an explanation of those things. Place the heading, children. Peninsular plateaus. The heading is about peninsular plateaus. Write on the first point. Peninsular plateau are of two types. The first one is central lands, and the second one is about Deccan. The central lands covers about the states from Gujarat to Odisha. Nearby, the ranges of Vindhya ranges and Satpura ranges, we have the Malwa Plateau, and to the eastern part of the country, we have Chota Nagpur Plateau at Odisha. Later on, if we move to the southern part of the country, we have another major plateau or plateau region, that is about Deccan Plateau. Clear, children? So, along with the plateau regions, we have two gods. One is about the western god, another one is about eastern god. The western gods are continuous, and the elevation of the western gods are about 2000 meters. And coming to the eastern gods is about 900 meters of elevation. Based upon the topography, topography in the sense the land, the clear children. So based upon the topography, as the land has been tilted towards east direction, the elevation of the western gods has been raised comparing to the eastern part. And write down the notes, children. Along with this, we'll give the clarity about the points. Coming to the first one, there are six groups of plateau regions. There are six groups of plateau region. In that, the first one, Archean. The first one is about Archean group. So what is this Archean group in the sense? Before, at the time of formation of the Indian subcontinent, the southern part has been taken as divided into six categories. So based upon this, the first one is about the Archean group. Write down the first point in this. It consists of old crystalline. It consists of old crystalline and metamorphosed or metamorphosed rocks. So if you go through about different types of the rocks, we have sedimentary rocks, metamorph crystalline rocks, and some red sand rocks will be there. So coming to the Archean group, the completely the land have or covered about the old crystalline or metamorphosed rocks. Clear children? And this found in the ranges of or the areas where the Archean group has been taken as Tamil Nadu, Nilgiris, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Nilgiris, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh. So these are all the four states where the rocks of old crystalline and metamorphosed rocks are available, and here we have about completely Archean group. Coming to the second group, second point in this, the Bengal Guinness known as, here we know the name, the eastern gods. As declaring or categorizing the name of the eastern gods, it has been named as eastern gods are named as, they have been named as condolite, condolite. A discontinuous god section has been taken part, where the eastern part of these states like Tamil Nadu, and coming to Karnataka doesn't have about the eastern part, but the rocks consists of old crystalline metamorphosed and AP, these are all comes under Archean group. Coming to the second one, the second group is about Dharwar system. The second one is about Dharwar system. So like Archean group, the another category is about Dharwar system, and it consists of sedimentary rocks. It consists of sedimentary rocks and metamorphosed rocks. As we know, comparing to the northern part, the southern part completely covers about the rock system, in the sense the plateau regions are completely about hilly regions and less rainfall is going to be taken, whereas comparing to the northern part. Why? What is the reason in the sense? Here the underground level of the water is less, and even though we have about the forest areas, because of the humidity and the climatic conditions, less rainfall is going to be taken in the southern part of the countries, whereas comparing to the northern part of the countries. So what are all the rocks here? Sedimentary rocks and metamorphosed rocks. And here it completely occur mainly from Dharwar, comma, Hospet and Bellary districts. The first part is about Dharwar district, Hospet district and Bellary district. This comes under the state Karnataka. This comes under the state Karnataka. Clear, children? And next one, here it is about Chotanagpur Plateau. It consists about Chotanagpur as the eastern border, as we discussed. So, Chotanagpur Plateau. Chotanagpur Plateau. And coming to the third one is about, here the variation has been laid from Godavari, Upper Godavari. As we know that, the origin place of the Godavari River has been taken from Maharashtra and it is going to merge with Bay of Bengal. So, what is the origin place here? The origin place of the Godavari is Nasik Trayambakeshwar. The origin place is about Nasik Trayambakeshwar. So, this Dharwad system also taken nearby the Upper Godavari. Clear, children? And coming to the fourth point in this, the fourth point is about this types of rocks are also found nearby Aravali ranges. Nearby Aravali ranges. And coming to the Aravali, Aravali mountains or the Aravali ranges have been taken near Rajasthan. The Aravali mountains or Aravali ranges have been taken nearby the Rajasthan. Clear, children? So, please note down these two points. The first one is about Aryan group and the second one is about Dharwar system. I am giving 2 minutes of the time. After completion of this, please raise the hands. We will move further. If you have completed, children, please raise the hands. We will move to the next topic. These are all the first two group divisions. What are all the first two group divisions? One is about Aryan group. Another one is about Dharwar system. So, we are moving to the next one, children. Today, we are noting about the additional information. Tomorrow, we will go through about the textual information, children. Tomorrow, in the sense, in the next class, coming Friday. And maximum by Monday, we will complete the chapter. Tuesday will be moving towards the map representation. After map representation, one day will be allotted for the complete doubt solution. Just few minutes till now. So, after completion of these two, we have another one, that is about Kadapa system. The third one is about Kadapa system. Yeah, in which state it comes under Kadapa? Yeah, Andhra Pradesh. Clear, children? Coming to the Kadapa system, here we have about the lower valleys. What is the meaning of a valley? The flow of the river is going to separate the soil. Because of the flow of the river, the land has been taken into the V shape, where we call it a V shaped valleys. And coming to the U shaped valleys, the valleys which have been formed because of glaciers. Clear? But here in the southern part, we don't have any type of the glaciers. We have only about V shaped valleys. So here the valleys have been taken part between Penganga and Godavari. So, Penganga and Godavari. The river merging is going to be taken. So, because of these valleys, the separation of the rocks has been taken. And as we discussed earlier, the igneous rocks are going to melt in the water. Clear? So, here we have about taches between Mahanadi and Brahmani, the rivers Brahmani rivers. So these are all the two major rivers. So the origin place of the, or where the Mahanadi and the Brahmani rivers are going to be taken, are nearby Odisha and near to the border of Kolkata, West Bengal. Clear, children? So the Mahanadi and the Brahmani rivers, in the sense, the Kadapa system, in the sense, the rocks where huge availability have been taken part in the Kadapa are also going to be taken in some of the areas like near Mahanadi river and near Brahmani river. And the next point is about, to the west of Aravallis, the rocks are completely are about metamorphosed and crystalline rocks. So these rocks where availability is going to be taken in the western part, nearby Aravallis to the western part of the country. And whereas if you go to the central part, it comes under what is the central part here? Yeah, nearby the Vindhya and Satpura ranges, the rocks are available, metamorphosed and crystalline rocks. And here, one more important, the resources more available nearby this Kadapa system are, the first one is about iron ore, second one is about manganese, third one is about copper, and the last one is about asbestos. So these are all the resources have been available nearby the Kadapa system. And coming to the fourth one, children, of the Kadapa system, we have Vindhya system. What is this system? The term system, in the sense, nearby the plateau regions, the resources and the rocks which have been available comes under the Vindhya system. So coming to the Vindhya ranges, we know that completely comes under central highlands. What are the central highlands? The lands or the land part which has been taken above to Vindhya ranges and parallel to Satpura ranges comes under the central highlands. If you go through about the peninsular plateau, children. Why? Because the word central has been discussed in the earlier classes. If you go through about Himalayas, central Himalayas. If you go through about another, the mountainous ranges, nearby the Himalayas, we have been used the word central. So here the central highlands completely comes under peninsular plateau of the country. So what are all the rocks are going to be taken? These rock pile completely occupies a huge area near from Rajasthan to Bihar. This is the land which has been taken continuously from Rajasthan to Bihar comes under central highlands in the Vindhya ranges. And what are all the rocks here? The rocks are red soil rocks and old crystalline. These are all the rocks are available in these lands, central highlands. Clear, children? And coming to what are all the major constructions or the major monuments which have been taken by the rocks which have been near these Vindhya ranges, the first one is about Sanchi Stupa. The first one is about Sanchi Stupa. In which state it comes under? Madhya Pradesh. And second one is about Agra Fort, Red Fort, Fatehar Forts. So completely, even if you go through about the Birla Temple in Hyderabad, in Telangana regions, these monuments are being constructed by using about huge valuable stones where these stones are available nearby the Vindhya system. So by using about such type of the stones, some of the Sanchi Stupa, Agra Fort, Red Fort, Fateh Ali Forts, and also the Birla Temple in Telangana, Birla Temple in Telangana have been constructed. So note down these two, children. 2 minutes of the time. After that, we'll move towards another one. After completion of this, please raise your hands. By that, we'll move towards another content. Just remember, children, these topics are not there in your regular textbooks. So please note down these. Yeah, children, we are moving to the another topic. After completion of the Vindhya ranges, the next one is about Gondwana system. What is the word indicates about the Gondwana? Yeah, in the beginning of the lesson, we discussed about the Indian subcontinent has been separated from the plate tectonics, and the formation of the Indian has been submerged with the northern part of the Asian continent or Eurasia. Asian continent or Eurasia, where we call it as the Gondwana part. So now coming to the Gondwana system. Few minutes. So note down in the meanwhile, here we have completely about the coal belts. So if you go through about Telangana region, we have one of the major coal belts, that is about SCCL. What is the full form of SCCL?
Yeah, write down.
Singareni Coal Collieries Limited. In the sense, Singareni coal mines comes under Telangana state. So in the meanwhile, or like Singareni coal mines, in the Gondwana system, the fifth one is about Gondwana system. The fifth one is about Gondwana system. So in the Gondwana system, completely in the peninsular region, we have about coal belts. Availability of the coal is going to be taken in the interior part of that. And coming to the India, but developed during the Gondwana, rocks preserved. Here the rocks are preserved completely, if you go through about coal, the natural and the artificial coals are going to be taken. So the natural coal in the sense which has been available from the interior part of the land, whereas the artificial one is about charcoal. What is this charcoal in the sense? By burning about the trees, we will get about the coal. In the sense, completely after burning of the trees, the coal is going to be taken where we call it as a charcoal. So in the Gondwana system, completely we have naturally formed coal beds. So here the rocks completely, because of the temperature, they have been changed like the coal with mixing of some minerals and chemicals, which have been taken or which are available in the interior part of the earth. So here especially, if you go through about the Gondwana system, huge amount of diamonds availability are there. Huge amount of the diamonds availability are there. If you go through the western part, nearby Aravalis, and if you go through about southern part, we have some of the districts in Andhra Pradesh, that is about Kurnool district and also Anantapur district, we can find some of the gold mines. But because of the permissions from the government, completely it comes under the government sector. No other person have the rights to go through digging about the earth and to collect about the gold or the diamonds here. And here water on the rivers have been flown here. This is about Damodar, Mahanadi, Damodar, Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna. Damodar, Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna. Clear children? So this is about the Gondwana system. And the last sixth system, the last sixth system is about Deccan system. So the Deccan Plateau completely comes under Deccan Plateau. But actually the thing is about Deccan Plateau is a huge part, completely covers about the majority of the states in the southern part. If you go through from bottom, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, partial part or half part of Madhya Pradesh and Odisha. These are all the states comes under the Deccan system. Deccan system or Deccan Plateaus. And what type of the rocks are available here? In the Deccan Plateaus, the rocks which have been available are sedimentary rocks. The rocks are sedimentary, pervious and igneous or igneous rocks are available in the Deccan system. And here also we can find some of the rivers, major rivers like Krishna, Godavari, Tungabhadra, Penna, Kaveri. These are all the rivers have been flown here. So because of the flow of the rivers, we have some valleys and deltas. And nearby this Deccan system only, the god sections and the land part, huge amount of the resources have been taken part nearby the Deccan system. Whereas the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats are going to be completely covered under this Deccan system. So what are the Ghats here? Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. And here if you observe clearly children, comparing to the remaining parts of the system like Gondwana system, Kadapa system, especially nearby the Deccan system, we find a huge amount of the soil. What type of soil? That is about black soil. Huge amount of the black soil. What is the use and what all the crops are going to be cultivated nearby the Deccan system? The first one is about cotton. And remaining crops majorly which have been grown in the Deccan system are about cotton, rice, maize. It's clear children? These are all the crops are being grown in the Deccan system. Clear? Yeah, I'm giving a 2 minutes of the time. Please note it down. We'll move further. This Deccan system is also called as Deccan Trap. TRAP. If you have completed, please raise your hands and don't neglect to write the notes, because familiarly we will get such type of the notes where you don't find in your regular textbooks. Clear, children? As it is useful for the NTSC, not only for NTSC, for any type of the competitive exams, like some of the examinations have been taken. So this information will be helpful for you. Yeah, note it down. After 2 minutes, I am going to go through another topic. As some of the students have been gone through, send me the messages. I am giving information for the students. By Sunday, I am going to give the notes which you required for these topics what we have been discussing. And next, coming to the next subject, major rivers which have been flown in Deccan Plateau or the Plateau regions. Major rivers flow nearby the Plateau regions. Please make the heading. So as we discussed in the beginning of the session, the Plateau regions have been taken as three types: Malwa, Deccan and Chotanagpur Plateaus. So nearby Malwa Plateau, we have major two parallel rivers. One is Narmada and Tapati. In NTSC, they may ask into different types of questions: what are all the rivers or what are all the parallel rivers? So that is the reason, especially we are focusing on the rivers in the Himalayan regions. So coming to the first one, the rivers nearby the Malwa Plateau are Narmada, Tapi, Mahi, Sabarmati and Luni. Actually it comes under Rajasthan, but a little part of the Rajasthan comes under Aravalli ranges. So in the central highlands, we have about these are all the major rivers. In the western part, where it comes under? It comes under Malwa Plateau. It comes under Malwa Plateau. Coming to the eastern part, nearby Odisha and West Bengal, we have some of important rivers. Like the first one is about Damodar, which are being connected to the Chotanagpur. Only few, a less percentage of the river water is going to be connected to the Chotanagpur plateaus. So the rivers are about Damodar, and the next one is about Teesta, Mahanadi and Brahmani. And if we compare here, if we go through about the another important point, nearby the West Bengal, we have one of the important mountainous range is about Rajmahal Hills. So what are all the hills? Rajmahal Hills nearby the West Bengal. This comes under the eastern part. Clear, children? If we go through about the southern part, nearby the Deccan Plateau, the rivers majorly which have been originated, the first important river, if we go through about asking what is the longest or largest peninsular river, the longest or largest peninsular river is about River Godavari. So River Godavari at Nasik Trimakeshwar, Maharashtra, and River Krishna. After this, पेन्ना, कावेरी. So these are all the rivers have been flown nearby Deccan Plateau towards east, and as we discussed earlier, towards west, one of the river, the important river is about Netravati River, and one more important river is about towards east is about Tungabhadra River. The another important river is about Tungabhadra River, where these rivers have been taken in Deccan Plateau. So why we are discussing about the rivers here in the sense, because of the flow of the rivers, the formation of valleys has been taken. The formation of the valleys, hilly regions have been taken, and the, in the sense the land has been taken into the V-shaped valleys. So especially if you go through about the Nilgiri Hills, if you go through about Nilgiri Hills, we find such type of the valleys. Even though while we are moving to some of the regions, we find about the ghat sections, the continuous hill sections have been taken. So because of flow of the rivers, the valleys have been formed, especially Nilgiris and nearby Anaimudi. Anaimudi comes under which state? It comes under Kerala. Clear, children? To remember, or one of the short note for the Anaimudi is about, just remember the capital of Kerala, Thiruvananthapuram or Trivandrum. Why? What is the reason? It is a place where both the western gods and eastern gods are going to mix. Clear, children? And the highest peak in the southern plateau is about, or southern part of the country is about Doddabetta. Clear? So these are all the topics for today. Tomorrow we are going to discuss about the Nilgiri Mountains and remaining things. Let's have a glance regarding about the topics what we discussed today. Coming to the peninsular plateau, the word peninsular comes under the land which have been covered with water of three sides is called as peninsular. So India is a peninsular plateau. Peninsular plateau has been categorized into two types. The first one is about the central highlands, and the second one is about Deccan plateau. So nearby the central highlands or central plateaus, we have two important plateaus. The first one is about Malwa plateau towards the west direction of our country, or towards west of the Indian part between Vindhya ranges and Satpura ranges. And here what all the rivers have been originated, or what all the rivers have been flown? River Narmada and River Tapi. Clear? And quite opposite to or nearby Odisha, we have one more plateau region, that is about Chota Nagpur plateau. Clear, children? And the next one is about Deccan plateaus. Among these plateaus or continuous plateaus, we have two ghat sections. The first one is about western ghats, and the second one is about eastern ghats. The elevation of the western ghats is about 2000 meters, and the elevation of the eastern ghats is about 900 meters. Western ghats are continuous ghats formation section, whereas if you go through about the eastern ghats, are not continuous. They are non-continuous ghat sections because of the deltas. How the deltas have been formed? Because of the flow of the rivers. What are all the rivers? Especially Godavari, Krishna, Penna, Kaveri, Tungabhadra. So these are all the rivers have been flown towards east direction. So nearby the eastern ghats, we have continuous deltas has been taken, but non-continuous ghat section is going to be taken nearby the eastern ghats. And the plateau regions have been categorized into six types. So we have been gone through learning about those six types: Deccan trap, and next one is about Kadapa system and Dharwa system. So completely six divisions of the plateau regions have been taken part. And tomorrow we are going to discuss about the Nilgiri Mountains and Doddabetta ranges, and the elevations of each and everything in the Deccan plateau regions.